YouTube, social media world. It's your boy Anonymous Based, and I'm biggity biggity bat with a new reaction video. This time I'm here with something brand new from It's Complicated. But before we get into that, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and give this video a like. Share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section. So, we're here with something brand new from It's Complicated. Shout out to you, brother. Dom DeMarco. And the name of this video is called Burden of Performance: Rules of Modern Dating and Understanding Women. All right, let's go ahead and get into it, man. Because I already know there's going to be some lying going on. But we're going to see how the conversation goes.
Oh, man. Okay, so there is a big red pill craze going on, especially with the whole Andrew Tate thing. And with women, there is a big difference. And basically, these red pill guys, they are trying to teach men that men are superior, men are the alphas, men should walk around with the sword, and women should do what they say and cook their dinner, and that's how it is. And you should be their first. You should be their first experiences. And I say, fuck all that shit. For women, I think women need to really get in touch with their feminine power, and they need to realize that they are in control. They are the ones that make the decisions and
stop the cap.
This is like when they're in a relationship and even before in dating. Like, I think now with Tinder and Bumble and all these other dating apps, it feels like it's just normal to you meet a guy and then you have sex with him on the first date. And it's like, ladies, dinner is not enough. Like, let this guy work for you, or give this guy, like, make him earn it, you know? He needs to do something, whether it's financial, whether it's effort, more than just a dinner, because it's like that.
Find it, try it, paint it, love it. Find it, try it, paint it, love it. Find it, try
it. This is one of the few times where I actually agree with the ads intervening with the video.
At Blue Bunny, we test to make sure our mini treats are crunchy and mini. Thor!
Oh, beautiful.
Sorry!
So, does it feel mini enough for you?
Yeah.
Approved. Blue Bunny, we make fun.
Like that, this is what's going on with a lot of my girlfriends.
It's been said that men have a burden of performance that women don't. Who assigns them that burden, and isn't that the problem right there?
Men do. They compete with each other.
I guess it's society kind of that assigns that burden, or maybe they do it to themselves.
Well, I mean, we kind of do have a burden to perform because there's more competition with men.
Yep. Women, men, they love women. Women can never do wrong. Men do and should work harder, because if you are going to get in a relationship, whether it's long-term, short-term, you have to provide. You have to be a provider. You have to be ready for that next step.
Why is the man's provider gender role more demanding than the woman's was, is, or ever will be?
That's hard.
Because
I think women have less defined roles in society nowadays. I think they could kind of float and do whatever they want, but a man is expected to be a provider economically
all the time.
That's pretty much the difference, is women have, you know, the choice. They could kind of be the house mom and do that type of thing, or they could do it for themselves and provide for themselves. A man that doesn't work and doesn't provide or doesn't have a family doesn't have much value in today's society.
Is the pressure greater on men to be successful or on women to be beautiful?
They expect women to be beautiful throughout their life.
I would say men to be successful, because I feel like now we've kind of moved over to society saying like every woman is beautiful. So I think there's more of a pressure for men to be successful and be the provider of the household.
I don't know. I think I might say women to be beautiful, just because I think that, like, if I were to go out and, like, meet a guy, I mean, my assumption and my experience is that he would have to think I'm beautiful for me even to find out if he's successful.
The average man's salary in the U.S. is $40,000. The average woman in the U.S. weighs 170 pounds. Why is there a fat acceptance movement for women, but there's no broke acceptance movement for men?
Whoa, man, that's deep. That's deep. And there just is unattractive features as much as a low-income man is unattractive to women. Overweight women are unattractive to a large swath of the male population. I think, you know, a lot of us have to settle for what's out there. Not myself, but...
We're expected as men to kind of like settle for a woman as men.
Here we go, y'all. The septum piercings have made another return. And what do I always say about the septum piercings? Red flag. Something wrong with them. Now, I'm going to give her... I don't know if I really want to give her the benefit of the doubt, because I can kind of just tell off rip that she's going to say some nonsense, but we're going to go ahead and see what she says anyway.
She is. Why don't women typically settle for a man as he is?
I don't think there's a correlation. I think, like, women are... can be beautiful no matter what shape or size they come in, but
stop the cap.
I don't think there's like
here
I don't
we go.
Think men that don't have money are being like discriminated against.
Women have are born with value because as I'm an adult grown woman now, men love my feet, men love my ass, men love my hair or other attributes. Where men can put themselves in that position. But if they aren't those type of guys, then if they're not naturally built, then they do have to create it.
Okay, why do women have a burden of performance to become better partners if they don't want to be viewed as a mere sexual object?
That's a good question. I think that's it needs to be. Women need to be more held accountable if they want to be viewed as being equal.
Y'all ain't holding them accountable, though.
As much responsibility and you know, if they want to have the say-so, they need to have the responsibility and do half the work.
Because I do think that there's a level of hypocrisy in my gender.
They ain't gonna do that, though.
In women, I do think that we want it all, but we don't necessarily want to have to, like, admit any sort of change that needs to happen on our behalf. I mean, I probably need to change, but
how do we fix that?
Give it 100 years.
Well, doesn't that mean that a lot of women are gonna die lonely cat ladies?
They could. I mean, I might.
Who cares more about masculinity, men or women?
I would say women.
Are men conditioned by other men to act a certain way?
100%.
Yes, 110%. I think it's a big contest sometimes between men, and they try to act like it's for women, but really they're pinning themselves against each other.
Are women conditioned by other women to act a certain way?
I don't think so.
Yes, they are.
There's more of a freedom.
Stop the cap.
I wouldn't say conditioned, but definitely cheered on.
Does a man have the right to define what a woman is?
No.
So then what gives women the right to define what a real man is?
They don't. But at the same time, it might help a man get what they want from a woman.
If we're talking about what we're willing to date and marry, of what we consider, what we deem a worthy woman to marry or have children with or whatever, but I don't think we have the right to define the role of what is a woman.
Why do women think they have the right to define what
Stop
a real man
cap.
Is?
Look, can't even say nothing.
Common use term of woman, yeah.
Can't even say nothing.
It's kind of like a dig on men to, you know, like we were talking about masculinity. It's kind of like a dig to make a man feel less than, to say he's not a man or whatever, or he's...
Good dude, man.
Not, and the same connotation really doesn't work with women. You don't tell a woman if she can't cook or clean or do any of the traditional womanly roles or take care of kids. You don't tell her that she's not a woman. So it is like a double standard for sure.
Exactly.
Who gets to decide what a man should or should not be?
The man.
The man himself gets to decide what he wants to be or what he doesn't want to be for his own self, but not for anyone else.
Who gets to decide what a man should or should not be?
The Bible.
Who is more attractive, liberal or conservative men, and why?
Unfortunately, I would say conservative.
I would say conservative.
Well, we're going to disagree.
We're definitely going to disagree.
Conservative, definitely.
Liberal, because I like a man who supports women and supports a lot of things that conservative men just do.
And I like a man. And I like the blue-collared, hard-working man.
I would say that conservative men tend to adopt the traditional idea of what a man is, so they're strong and they're...
And that's what y'all want!
Men. They usually have a more open mind.
Stop the cap.
I think.
And I think they actually care about people more.
Yeah.
I think a lot of Republicans care about money. And liberal men are definitely more progressive and open-minded and just better in general, in my opinion.
What's the difference between feminist women shaming men for being men and traditional women shaming men for not being real men?
Tradcons are undercover feminists.
Wouldn't that equate modern misandry to feminism and traditional misandry to chivalry?
Yes.
Don't both place women at a status above men?
Feminism is a woman supremacy movement.
Yep.
What are your thoughts on the following statement? Women are born with value, men have to create their value.
I agree with it.
You agree with it? Okay.
I do agree with it.
It's true.
What if I told you some races are born with value, others have to create their value? Would that be okay?
It's true. I don't know if it's okay.
How is that not bigotry?
It is.
Why is saying men have to create their value not sexist?
It is sexist.
But it's true, though.
Are men born with the muscles, money, and status that attract most women?
No.
No.
If men are more likely to work for their value, don't they deserve more respect for that?
Absolutely.
If men have to accept that they need to work harder in the dating market, why can't women accept that they need to work harder in the job market?
I think men opted out.
I mean, personally, I don't agree with that. In societal terms, you're probably right. It's like, because, you know, we touched on the economic issue, and a woman could easily not have money and just meet a rich man if she's gorgeous. And yeah, I get the point of that. But me personally, I would never buy too much into just looks. There's you know, more to people than that.
What if I told you that some races are born with value, other races have to create their value? Would that be okay?
No, it's not okay. It's not true. You know, the individual creates his value every day by his actions.
Certain races are more valuable than the other. It's definitely true that that happens, and that's a big part of racism and a lot of the issues that we still face today and have not overcame yet.
So then why would it not be a problem when that applies to men? Because men aren't typically born with the muscles, money, and status that attract most women. So that's basically saying that men aren't valuable until they achieve those things.
Did I say that beforehand? I don't agree with that. I think that everyone is valuable in their own ways, and regardless of your social status or your gender identity or your sexual orientation or whatever. But
stop the cap.
No, I don't think the material things that you own or have access to define your value as a person.
So then why is saying men have to create their value not sexist?
It is sexist, you know. But like we were saying earlier, it's not just women that hold men to that standard, it's other men.
It's not sexist because there is an expectance from men when you get in a relationship. Women, we focus on an ideal man, we need a provider. Because if we end up in a situation carrying your child or anything other of that sort, you need to be able to provide. So that's why men do need to create value.
Does a woman provide children for every man she dates?
No.
So until that woman is having that man's kids, why does he need to provide anything?
Being in a relationship, she has options. She doesn't have to be with you. She's just choosing to be with you.
So basically, wouldn't that mean that in order for a man to get the perks, aka sexual access, he basically has to submit to the woman's terms?
I do think it is a two-way street because she has to play her part.
Which is what?
To earn his value.
Which is what?
It shouldn't be accepted that, oh, he just expects his sexual favors just for being him.
Are women doing men a favor by giving them sex?
No. I mean, yes, gotcha, and bitch. No.
Come on, bro.
That's a hard one, actually.
Fuck nigga to
what's
the end, tell a friend,
a
bitch.
A woman telling a man, I'm not your property, and a man telling a woman, I'm not your provider.
There's really no difference.
Cal, look into the fire. It will warm you.
Man, what's up with these ads, bro? I can't even skip them.
Consume everything.
I live for Saturdays at Saturdays.
And me and my crew stay ready.
Saturdays on Disney Channel and Disney Plus.
No difference.
Property would be like you own the person. I don't think anybody is owned, but if they're the provider and they're saying that they're owning it?
Yeah, I mean, you're asking what's the difference between it?
Well, in other words, why should a man have responsibility without authority?
Well, because, well, statistically, I mean, men have had that for hundreds of years, and women have never had the authority to be their own person.
Yeah, I think it's just basic respect not to be treated like an object, whether you're the provider or not. It's not.
There's a lot of roles that the women play as well.
Yeah.
Like that mindset of women are your property leads like to sexual violence and...
I was not ready for these questions.
Uh-huh.
Honestly, I feel like it's the same thing. I do. I feel like it's the same thing. As women, we look at men as providers, and as men, sometimes they can be very possessive and very dominant. And from that standpoint, that's just how it happens.
But that's what y'all are attracted to.
Why should a man have responsibility without authority?
Gotcha, bitch.
I was not ready for these questions.
Oh, man, goddamn.
Why should a man have responsibility without authority?
Over who?
In other words, if a woman expects a man to provide, doesn't he have the right to set down some ground rules?
Of course.
So then wouldn't that mean that she's his property in a sense?
No, not at all.
What? So
how would you clarify that?
Well, I think in a relationship, there's always compromise that's going to need to happen. So if there's a prearranged agreement that a man is going to provide, that's an agreement that needs to be made between the two of them, and that by no means makes the woman his property whatsoever.
Well, in other words, like a lot of women might feel like the guy's being controlling if he says, hey, I don't want you going out dressed like that. I'm trying to look out for your well-being or your
safety.
Yeah,
no, that's not okay.
So then would it be okay for a woman to expect a man to be responsible for her, you know, for her?
Not necessarily.
Uh-huh.
Just because you're, like, paying bills doesn't mean you can tell someone, like, what they can and can't wear.
I don't know. I don't mind being property at this point.
There's always going to be a level of misogyny that comes with masculinity. It's a double-edged sword. I think women kind of understand that dynamic. And you see with Andrew Tate's and these type of guys that are labeled as misogynists, they still have no shortage of female suitors that
exactly.
are tied into that, that would rather be in a submissive state and be dominated by a very masculine personality.
Is giving birth more of a privilege or burden for women?
Burden.
It's both, because it messes with your body a little bit, but on another level, you're bringing another human being into the world.
I think it's a blessing. It is a privilege. It's
a blessing.
Some women think it's a burden because they're selfish about their own bodies, and that's all I feel, because I think it's a blessing. Every child is a blessing. I got two of them.
Is providing for a family more of a privilege or burden for men?
You could argue it's both.
Every man should be proud to take care of your family, no matter what. I'll drop everything to do it. I'll give everything to do it. I'll give my own soul, just like Jesus did.
Yep.
How likely are men to leave if their wife can't bear children?
They do.
No, I don't think it's likely. Most men don't even want kids.
I think that most men that want children, at least in my experience, they'd be fine with adopting
or any of the in vitro, things like that.
How likely are women to stay if their man can't provide?
They don't.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I don't know too many that's going to
stay.
Okay, so then wouldn't providing for a family be more of a burden for a man?
No, not really.
Well, I mean, it's a responsibility. If he doesn't meet that responsibility, she's going to leave, right?
Yeah, she obligated to leave. She can leave if she feel like he's not going to provide, but I don't think it's a burden.
How does being masculine help men who are screwed over by the family court system?
Oh, man, that's great. I don't think it helps at all. I think if you're too masculine, you're seen as obtrusive and, aggressive and all these negative traits that are actually, you know, scary traits or would make you look like an abuser or make less trustworthy with the child and all these things. So, yeah, it's actually bad to be super masculine when it comes to the court system.
It doesn't help them at all. There's nothing they could do for it to help them.
How does being masculine help men who are falsely accused?
It doesn't.
Whether a man is masculine or not, doesn't he still deserve equal justice?
Absolutely. Yeah. Yes, especially when it comes to children.
So why is there so much talk about masculinity rather than men's rights?
I would argue there is talk about it. It just doesn't hit the mainstream media.
I think there's a war on masculinity that's going on right now. To be honest with you, they want men to be more submissive and docile in a certain type of way. But the truth is, it's kind of like still not attractive to women at the same time. And I'm talking about more of the, you know, the more attractive women that would be out there that most men desire. Mm-hmm. They're still into more masculine men.
Why do women often attack a man's masculinity when they don't get what they want?
Why is it that women say the man is gay when they reject them?
Exactly.
Because I think that's the heart of their ego. I would say that looks are the heart of women's ego.
Why are women so welcoming of the gay community, yet so quick to shame a man as gay when they don't get what they want?
I said the same thing, bro.
Double standard. Yeah, that's true.
I said the same thing.
Not that they don't get what they want. It's that they're rejected and they cannot even fathom the thought that maybe they're just not attractive to the guy.
Again, that's just the easiest way to attack a man's pride is, you know, say he's gay or imply that he's weak or any of those type of things. Make him feel less than. He's not good enough for you.
It's often said life isn't fair. Who is more likely to be expected to accept injustice, men or women?
I think that's an easy one. Men.
If it's not men, why do we have the expression, take it like a man?
Because men are statistically and just biologically more strong than women.
So men are just expected to take abuse?
No, but biologically, men are stronger than women.
What are they going to say? They already have the Duluth model, which automatically presumes that the man is guilty when the police show up.
Because men are supposed to take a lot of shit and handle it and be hard and strong. And that's what's accepted of a man. And if you don't do that, then you're considered weak.
All right, okay, man. Shout out to It's Complicated for coming through with yet another fire compilation of interviews called Burden of Performance. All right, so me watching this for the first time, this was very, very interesting because the way he phrased the questions was put in a way to get some of these people to question the logic of the fabric of society when it comes to the laws and how things are regulated, right? Because a lot of the way they were going to phrase their answers was based on women being the lesser, as in being the ones that are the ones that are at the disadvantage, when in reality, his line of questioning started to peel the layers back. And it started to get them to see the other side to say, wait a minute, women aren't really the ones that are the ones that have the disadvantage. It's really the guys. So the way he phrases the questions to get them to see his logic is kind of how I debate as well. That's typically my debate style, right? I don't go in telling people that they're right or wrong. I just challenge their logic and I trap them. I get them in a corner to where they have no choice but to see it from my side. And even then, I can phrase a question in a way to get them to contradict themselves too. So I don't need to go in telling people that they're right or wrong. Just like my boy doesn't. But overall, it was a great video. I had to call out a bunch of cap like normal. But overall, I don't take anything away from this man's work. He's out here doing God's work. He's out here stirring up controversy, but he's not really doing that. He's stirring up reactions to get people to continue the conversation that the late, great Kevin Samuels had started a few years ago. So overall, man, great video. I'm looking forward to meeting you in person and getting in on some of these conversations because I want to trap these people with some logic too. So shout out to you, man. And that's pretty much my reaction, man. So if you like the video, go ahead and give this video a like. Share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section, man. It's your boy, Nonymous Based. Peace.